we're always coming down here from the Bronx. We like leave the house at midnight and take the subway all the way down and hang out all night. And I'd go straight to school.
What was these fields like then?
It was really different. Nobody came down here. Nobody wanted to shop here or live here.
Mm-hmm.
Just a few diehard punk rockers. And we got so much press when we opened because we were the first punk rock store in America that, you know, people came because of that. Otherwise, we would have died because nobody wanted to come down here.
How did you get the publicity? Did you send stuff out saying you were going to be a punk rock store?
No. We were singers and we knew a lot of people. We just told everyone we were opening a store. And then this woman, Toby Goldstein, who wrote for, I think it was Roxine, or one of those magazines, she heard about us somehow that we were, we had opened, but we didn't have our big opening party or grand opening. We were sort of open just for our friends, but not really. And she heard about it somehow, I don't know. So she called us and she was really into the idea and really wanted to help us. So she sent out a lot of invitations to people in the press that she knew. And so we opened. But if we made $6 in a day, we thought, wow, that's great, $2 each, we can go have pizza. We just, like, the rent was really cheap because, you know, nobody wanted to move in here. And we hardly had anything in the store. We just, like, brought stuff down from our rooms at home and a few other things we'd pick up.
Did you order punk rock paraphernalia from England at all, or?
No, you couldn't really order punk rock paraphernalia back then. We went over once with our partner, Gina, and brought stuff back from seditionaries and the hair dye, crazy color hair dye. We brought that back. But then there was really no punk look. We just like decided to sell what we liked, and that sort of became the punk look.
Right.
I guess it was in 75 we were in Blondie. We did backups.
Was the band called Blondie?
Yeah, it was called Blondie and the Bonsai Babies.
And who was in the band?
Blondie. Debbie, me, Tish, Chris, Fred Smith, who was in television for a while.
Sure.
We did a Shangri-La song called Give Us Your Blessings.
We did Lady Marmalade.
Yeah, I remember that.
And we did Dirty Old Man.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think we even got to Rock and Roll Baby.
I just thought I'd pick on you.
We got 86 before.
Were you into like the glitter scene? Is that what the big thing was? Max's, basically? And you were wearing platform shoes and describe the look that you had then.
It was kind of, at that point it was kind of in between glitter and punk for us because sometimes we were wearing platforms and sometimes we were wearing spike heels.
Leopard.
A lot of leopard and zebra. It was the same old shit. Really.
Do you have a favorite band?
Vinyl, miniskirts. The Ramones.
We'll be right back.
favorite band back then.
That was the band you would go see anytime, anywhere?
Mm-hmm.
Was that the only one?
We were their only fans!
We'd go to CBGB's and the two of us would be standing at the side of the stage and the place would be empty.
Of course, they don't remember us now.
Really, they don't?
They do.
Well, no, they do. And we never run into anything, really. But, you know, no, they do know us.
We used to play with them when we were in Blondie. They used to open for us or we'd open for them.
That place uptown, Brandy's, that we used to play in, we got the Ramones to open for us there, and they asked them to leave after the first set because they wouldn't turn down, and they did, "Now I want to sniff some glue," so that they were going crazy. It must have been 74, I think. It was whenever the Palm Casino Review was.
Yeah,
that we were
that
in.
Was 7.
Well, the Palm Casino Review was about... it was too long. It should have been about 45 minutes and must have been about 2 hours, right? It was really way too long. And they had about 20 people in the show. And everybody did different things. There were drag queens in the show. There were...
doing campy songs or what?
Yeah, doing campy stuff. And they even... they had a...
Streakers.
Streakers! Right.
Streakers was a big thing then.
I think it had just gotten popular, so we had, in the middle of the show, a few people would always streak through the audience. And, you know, the performers on stage would just kind of look at them, you know, as if they went nuts or something.
Right.
It was funny. It was a very good show.
There was a ballet troupe that did a number.
It was really an incredible show.
And what did you do in the show?
We sang, we were the word from the sponsor, sort of. We just did this thing as a joke. We did the Double Mint commercial, which was back there, that went, "Chewing gum can be fun when the taste is, and when the taste is double good." And we did it with "Taste So Fucking Good." And we were like these sort of like obscene, Doublemint girls,
twins.
Yeah, the Doublemint twins, only we'd, you know, give the audience the finger and smile at them, and, you know, it was really silly, but, and then we'd go into a little tap dance, and then we were Moonbeams.
Oh, yeah, the grand finale Moonbeam number.
We were Moonbeams. We were, like, in these giant headdresses with giant, you know, the, like,
chorus girl
chorus,
type.
Busby Berkeley kind of outfits, like, walking around like that. It was fun. Tomato sang "Devil with a Blue Dress On," and Gorilla danced with an inflatable doll
in a see-through plastic tuxedo.
That's great.
With his big wig.
And I remember Dee Dee always used to come to see us because his girlfriend, Sweet Pam, was in it.
Oh, yeah.
Dee Dee Ramone.
Are there any like memorable moments that really come to mind from Club 57? Any anecdotes that you particularly...
That Lawrence Wilk salute to the 70s thing, and no one had rehearsed.
There were no rehearsals for that.
And
it was so awful.
And everybody in the cast was like drunk or stoned.
No, they took Quaaludes so that they would be slow and old.
Do you
remember they all took Quaaludes so that they would so that they would look like really?
And nobody knew any of the words or anything, and the audience was like, "What?" We were all having a grand old time.
Hysterical.
Everybody in the cast had a great
laughing.
Time. I don't know about the audience. What was left of them by the end of the night?
Did you have much contact with Keith Haring or Kenny Scharf?
Kenny Scharf was one of our go-go boys when we used to play as Snooky and Tish with our band at Max's.
Mm-hmm.
He used to come up and go dance with John Six and this other guy, Drew.
Drew Straub. He was a go-go dancer for, Kenny was a go-go dancer for Klaus Nomi, too.
I mean, it was more fun. It was more fun having, like, you know, red or purple hair back then in 77. Than now. I mean, now it's like, you know, boring already. I mean, it's like part of life. It's no big deal. But back then, it was fun having different color hair. And
people hassled you, right? I mean,
Yeah, actually, I even got I got punched out right outside the Mud Club. It was written up in The Voice or something like that. I was the night the Mud Club opened. We were leaving. It wasn't even open, actually. It was their pre-opening party, and Shrapnel was playing or something. It was right after, was that after the Punk Awards or something? You were away or something?
Yeah.
That's right, it was the Punk Awards. I don't know if you heard about that, but they had, Punk Magazine held the Punk Awards down at that theater down the, someplace down the block, in a grill place or whatever it is, one of those places down the block on 2nd Avenue. And they had these punk awards, and everybody was, you know, getting different awards for different things and stuff.
Do you remember any of the awards?
I gave one out, and it was, like, really funny because they handed me one to read, and I, you know, do this. I forget what it was. I don't even remember what it was for, best such and such. And it turned out to be Blondie. I had to give the award to Blondie, so I was like, you know. It was really funny.
Was that after you?
I haven't made it yet, and I'm not in the band, and I have to give them an award. Wow, nice, but you know, that's all right. I don't think anybody from Blondie was there to accept it anyway. I think somebody staggered up like Spacely or something to accept the award. I don't know.